Hello everyone and welcome to the webinar of today. For those who don't know me yet, my name is Laura and I'm a part of the customer success team. So, before you want to make a dashboard, the first thing you need to do is connect your data, right? So that's the part we're gonna talk about today. Let's see what's on the agenda. First of all, I will tell you more about the possible data sources you can connect with in Cumulio. Next, I will tell you a little bit about the query performance and indicator to see how your query is doing. And last but not least, I will go to Cumulio, show you everything so you can see it for yourself. And afterwards, I will give a small recap. All right, let's get started, guys. First of all, I can imagine that you have some test data lying around, or maybe you made some exports somewhere. Then you can use the local upload possibility to upload files like CSV and Excel file. Know that if you want to refresh the data, you need to manually re-upload the Excel file or the CSV file. And keep in mind that the structure of the dataset needs to be the same. This means that if you want to add a new column to it, it needs to be at the back of the dataset to make sure that the structure of the columns are the same. So this is our most basic option, let's say. Next to that, we have our web services, which are services in the cloud with your data. You can have an overview of the ones you're connected with in your profile page, and there you can also easily disconnect and reconnect again to actually switch between your Google Drive accounts, for example. And an advantage of the web service possibility is that you can actually choose to do auto-synchronization, which means that your data will refresh automatically. And there you have some possible levels like every hour, every day, every week, as you desire. So that's a huge advantage that your data syncs automatically. All right, some examples are Google Drive and Asana. Next to that, we have our databases, which you can also see in your profile. And know that in your profile, you can also very easily switch from host URL, which means that, for example, you can first build a dashboard with your test data. Afterwards, you can change the host URL to the one of your production data, and the data in your dashboard will switch automatically. So you don't need to rebuild a new dashboard, which makes it actually very handy. And some examples are MongoDB, BigQuery, Elasticsearch as well, for example. So this is the databases, which I will also show you later in Cumulio. Know that if you have a database, the queries in Cumulio are live every time you open or reopen a dashboard, and also when you play around with the filters. So that's nice to know. It's live unless caching is activated in Cumulio. So what does this actually mean, caching? It means that the query results will be kept in cache or in memory for a period of time during which identical queries will be served from this cache. For example, you can say that you want to cache for 60 minutes. During those 60 minutes after opening your first dashboard or after making the first query, during those 60 minutes, the data will come from the cache, from the memory, every time you reopen the dashboard or when you play around with the filters. And when those 60 minutes are over and you're not doing anything anymore, nothing will happen in the cache. There will be no memory, unless after a period of time when someone reopens the dashboard again, a new query is fired, let's say, and that new query will be kept in the cache again. But know that it's the exact same query, so not the full dataset, all right? And you can actually make a cache on dataset level or on database level. And why would you do this? Why would you activate the caching? Because your dashboard will load much faster, because no new queries need to be fired all the time. So your dashboard will show results faster. Also know that if you want to connect a database, you need to give Cumulio access to your data. And you can do this by actually allowing our two IP addresses. You can do this on the firewall of your network. On that level, you're gonna allow the two IP addresses. And next to that, you will also allow your DB to actually have external questions like, hey, can we have your data? So that Camelio actually can get it, all right? Some people also use with security groups, and then you just allow our IP addresses on the level of the security group. Now for illustration, we have a small video so I can show you these two steps. Know that in the example we use AWS, but it's the same for other solutions or on local server as well. All right. So I will show you. So here we have our AWS management system, management console. And the first thing you need to do is create your security group. That you can easily do. You give it a small name and a small description so that you remember or that you know for which thing it is, let's say, why that you made a security group. And once you created the security group, you can actually allow our two IP addresses. And to know which ones those are, you can go to the Academy of Camelio and there you can search for the article containing our two IP addresses. You can just simply copy paste them and then don't forget to add the 32 at the end to make it work. All right, then you can also again give a small description as you desire, and then you can create the group, and afterwards you're going actually to link your database to the security group. That's the next step we will see in the little movie. And once you've done that, you can actually choose to give external accessibility to your database so that Camelio can get your data. So that you can make a beautiful dashboard out of it. And then the last step is actually the possibility to activate it immediately. Voilà. That was it. So that was a little movie about the two most important steps for actually allowing Camelio to get the data of your database. First, actually whitelist our two IP addresses, and then actually allow your database to get external queries. And it's the same for other solutions or your local servers as well. Then, next to the local upload possibility, the web services and the databases, we also have the possibility to add or create your own plugin. With this option, you can also connect to other web services for which we don't have a connection yet, like PyDrive or TeamLeader, or you can also connect to any API containing your data. And the advantage here is that it gives the possibility to actually add your own business logic because you actually created the code yourself. So you can really make it the way you desire. And know to help you out that we also have extensive documentation, which I'll show you in a minute. All right. And then the last possibility, which I just want to mention, is that we also have the possibility to push your data through API. All right, and we also have documentation for that on our Academy. So this is actually the beginnings page, let's say. In the middle, you have some explanations. At the left side, you see the content of the documentation. And at the right side, we actually have code snippets with some examples to help you out. Know that we also have different languages, so you can really get the ones you need. And in the middle, you have the explanation on what it is, how to do so, and you can just scroll through it and get other information as well. But know that you can always reach out to us if you need extra help. All right, so guys, this was already the first part about the possible data sources. Now let's go to the query performance. If you have created a dashboard and you have integrated it, for example, you desire a dashboard that loads very quickly, right? And to help you out to see where you can improve things, You can go to the dashboard editor, and in the chart you can actually see a performance indicator with some statistics on how the query performs. And then you can also see if the result is from cache or not. And it helps you to see where you can make some extra improvements to actually make your query go faster. Know that we have this information also on our academy, and here you actually see what the different parts of the query indicator mean, like checking if the query is well formed, to transforming it, to make the query wait in the room to be queried, and querying the query actually means that we're also waiting on the database of the client, and it also contains the processing of the results. And then we have the post-processing, and then of course the time that the front end needs to visualize the results. But you can find this on our academy as well. And then once you decide to actually improve your performance, we also have an article on our academy with more tips and tricks, like make your dashboard fit on one screen that you don't need to scroll down. Caching is also something that helps. You can also create materialized views on your database and maybe make some links in your DB as well. The best thing to do is to make sure that in Camelio you don't have too much links, which makes it very heavy. And also try to avoid using derived columns for calculations, so for metrics. But these are just some tips that we have more on the academy, so that's very handy if you want to improve the performance. All right, that was very short about that. Now the most important and the most excited part is going to Camelio, so I can show you everything on how to connect your data. So here we are in the dataset overview, where you can see the datasets that you have, but also the ones shared with you by members of your group or your organization, and also public ones. At the moment, we don't have any datasets yet, so let's go to new datasets and try to connect new ones. So on the left, you see the different parts, the different options we have. On top, you can also search for a connector. But first, let's go to the local file upload. This is very easy. Just click on browse, and then you see the documents on your laptop or on your computer. Just choose the one you want, click open, and then you see that it's in your dataset overview immediately. It just needs to upload, and then you see the dataset. The icon left from the name actually indicates the data source, which might be handy if you have multiple datasets. But now we remember that this is a local upload possibility. If you go to the more info, then you get the details of the dataset, and here you can actually see to re-upload your dataset to actually also have your newest data in it. And you can choose to actually replace all the data. You just click browse again, and you actually undertake the same steps as before. And then you see it's uploading, it's refreshing, and it's completed. So this means that your dataset now has the most recent data in it as well. So that's the very, very basic possibility to really upload a local file. Next, we have our web services like Google Drive. You just click on it, connect now, which will go to the sign in of your Google account. You choose the one you need. You allow Google Drive and Camelio to connect with each other. And then you click on Google Drive again, and there you have your data sets. And then you can search for the desired one. I have my fish again. You import it, and then you will see that it's analyzing and that it appears in your dataset overview immediately. It might take some time sometimes, but now you see the difference in the icon. So this is obviously the icon of Google Drive. And then when you go to more info again, you see that here you have the option to actually synchronize every hour, every day. So this web service has the auto-synchronization option, but know that some web services can also work with caching. So that's the cache from the databases, but some web services also have that. So you can also always go to the details of the dataset to see whether it's with auto-synchronization or with caching. Alright, so we had local upload, we had the web service, now we go to the databases. Let's try out PostgreSQL. Here you have some information you need to fill in, which I'll take for this one. So you fill in the needed information and then of course your password. And then you will see that at the bottom, again, we have our two IP addresses. As a reminder, let's say. Then you can click connect, and then here as well you can see all the possible data sets you have in your database. For example, let's go for this one. You could also click or activate multiple data sets in one. But now I have the training, United Widgets, sales, and you see again that the icon of the database appears here. Now, the last thing is the possibility to create your own plugin. You can go to the documentation from here as well, but if you click on create a plugin, you get directed to the plugin page in your profile. And here again, you just need to fill in the needed information, click create, and then you will see your plugin in the dataset window as well. So you can have the possibility to choose that one to connect with. Now here in your profile, you also have the connected accounts page where you can see the ones you're connected with. And from here you can very easily disconnect again and then connect again as well. And here is actually the possibility to change the host URL very easily, as I said before. So that's really handy. There you go. Now I showed you how to connect with all kind of databases or data sources, let's say. Now imagine that you have a dashboard. Let's make very quickly one. You add new dashboard, then you have the possibility to do the on-screen tour, and then you can actually make create a small dashboard, take the data set you want, and then put the data in a different data slots. Know that you can also click on the settings to actually really customize your dashboard. But the thing I wanted to show you is our query indicators, or the performance indicator, which you can find by going to the data settings of your chart and click on this little icon over here, and then you can see the query indicator as I explained before. And by hovering over it, you can actually see the timing, and then you can also see in which step of the process you need to or you can improve some things. Very handy, and you have this for every chart. All right, guys. Now, this was it already. I actually showed you everything in Camelio, from how to connect your different data sources to actually going to the details of a data set where you can see if it's caching or synchronization or how to re-upload your local file again. Very handy. So let's do the small recap already. So the possible data sources to connect with, you have very basic, the local upload where you can manually refresh your data. You have the web services where you have the possibility to auto-synchronize your data or by caching. Then you have the databases where you can also activate caching. And then you also have the option to create your own plugin or push your data through API. Next, know that if you want to work with a database, you need to allow our two IP addresses. And then you can also add your own business logic in case you create your own plugin. Then the query performance means that you have to actually have an indicator with some statistics on how the query performs, so you can see where you can improve small things. And with some performance tips you can find on our academy very easily. And then last but not least, I went to Camelio and showed you everything. All right, guys. So this was already the webinar for today. I hope you learned some new things and know that if you have questions left, you can always reach out to us and send an email to support@kumul.io, and we are very happy to help you out. All right, see you next time, guys, and have a great evening. Bye.